Adidas,
Gap,
Balenciaga,
Foot Locker
have all dropped Kanye. Let's talk about it. What is up, guys? Welcome back to the Shoebox Podcast. I'm your host, Chewy.
I'm your host, Oscar.
And let's get into it.
Episode 9.
Kanye.
What's the title of this video?
Adidas has left Kanye by the side of the road.
Kanye's roadkill. I like it.
Yeah, no, it is crazy, guys. Like, what has all transpired, like, in the last couple, like a week?
It's been like a week.
Yeah, and like, I thought what was going to happen was that Yeezy was going to leave Adidas.
We all did.
Like, when his contract was up, but I did not see this coming. So Adidas has terminated Kanye, and so has Gap and a lot of other places like Foot Locker, Balenciaga, Forbes, like anything like JP Morgan, anything that anybody who had association with Kanye has pretty much like
just cut ties.
Yeah. So like we're here to kind of educate you guys on like what's going to happen going forward.
I think we just start with just what happened a little bit.
Yeah.
For people who don't really know or catch up to speed. And then we can kind of dive into a little bit more of like what's gonna what we think might happen.
Yeah, yeah.
Sneaker enthusiasts and
yeah,
streetwear.
And yeah, like the resale community as
right,
well.
Right.
So yesterday?
Yesterday morning, yeah.
Yesterday morning, Adidas announced that they're terminating Kanye. They don't. Everything he's been saying hasn't really been matching with like their core beliefs as a company, and they're going to terminate him. And that's what like a lot of people have been seeing, but as like a consumer, like I'm not sure what they're going to do with the Yeezy product, and I think like that's what we're here for, to talk to you about. I think Oscar has a pretty good grasp on what's going on.
From what I understood was when Adidas announced that they were canceling or I guess terminating the contract with Kanye immediately, they mentioned in their post that they were going to basically stop doing any type of like business structure with Kanye, but a lot of products that were already in the waiting to be manufactured or already manufactured are going to continue to be finished and be sold. And so then basically anything that they had left of their inventory, I've already seen a little bit of like other stores started to like just shock drop some pairs. So I think they're just going to liquidate basically everything they have at the moment, finish up anything that was anticipated. I know we were talking about like the Pirate Blacks, something that was like supposed to be coming out. So
we're
hopefully
excited for those.
Come out.
Yeah,
and
we're
that's
excited
just an
those,
example
yeah.
I can think of is like that shoe, for example, if it's already manufactured, they'll probably just drop it. But they do own the rights. It's the biggest thing that I caught that for those shoe models. So looks like Kanye won't be able to take those shoe models or anything that they have designed with Adidas.
Got you.
And make it his own and sell on his own.
I think that was like a big misconception. Like, or people thought that like if he does his own thing, he's gonna take the 350, the 500, like the Wave Runners, take all those models with him and like just like rebrand them as just Yeezy, no Adidas.
Right.
But
right,
it's like actually interesting to like know that like no, like we own the rights to those designs. So like he has to do something completely different if he wants to do his own thing, you know?
Yeah, and I think the like how you're saying, like there's that whole idea of like both ways where Kanye can't just take that, but I think Adidas can't just take the Yeezy name either and put it on those products anymore. So if they do continue to make, which I personally don't think they will, but if they do continue to make those shoe models, we're going to have to remove all Yeezy brand, not only for the sake of the contract, but I think just associating themselves with him anymore.
Like the public perception of the shoe.
I think they're going to have to remove that regardless moving forward if they do continue. But like I said, that's basically what I'm understanding where it's at right now with that. And then Gap, I mean.
Yeah, like they're putting stuff on clearance or like they're just getting rid of the product in general. Yeah. Like it's like, I don't know what they're going to do with it, you know.
Gap is basically like, basically saying we're like done too, pulling products. It's all done for. I saw the Balenciaga collab too got removed immediately and stuff like that from stores. And I know they had a lot of that stuff laying around. So
so
that was like immediately removed.
And I was like, I had a funny joke about like they should just do like a Yeezy Day 2 and like just drop everything that they have in their inventory like tomorrow and
like
just
clearance
like
it out.
Just like going away, like a going away sale for like Kanye. Like Kanye's going away. Here's all the shoes. Buy them now. Like. And like just see what happens, but I don't know if they're gonna do that. I think they'll still do like the monthly release or like every 2 weeks drop a shoe.
Yeah, I think they're going to keep to some type of a schedule and release some stuff.
Yeah.
With Gap, though, I don't know if they just immediately just stopped, though.
I think what I've heard is like clearance, but also just taking product out, too. So I'm pretty sure they're probably stopping production on the clothing. Yeah. And then like whatever they have left, they're either going to pull it or like maybe sell it for clearance, a discounted price, you know.
Sell it to like the Burlingtons and Ross of the world.
I think that'd probably be the better thing to do and just kind of like get it out of like their stores. Mm-hmm. And then like, or that, or like they can take a tax break and just donate all the stuff, which is what a lot of people would do. Like, I don't know. I think that was like another thing that was coming to my head, like Adidas and like all these other companies that have Yeezy product, they can just donate it and like take a tax break for it.
Yeah, yeah. And again, like, I think we got to go back to like the whole reason I think they're canceling. It's going to be kind of hard, I feel like.
To donate stuff.
Because I feel like it's starting to become a thing where they're kind of like all just falling in like an order where it's all like, if they do it, then we're going to have to as well, like,
not
type of business with them.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard. I mean, donating it, I guess, would be the coolest thing to, like, whoever really wants it.
Mm-hmm. But so, clearancing, I think maybe just, clearancing it and just stopping the production and then maybe just selling it to, like, Ross and Burlington, like those kind of stores. Which would be really funny to see a $300 hoodie for like $10 at Ross.
Interesting, but kind of off topic, but I had heard that you can find like Yeezy like a season like two and season like all the early Yeezy stuff. Gotcha. Ended up actually making its way into like those like department stores like that.
Yeah.
But that was just like what I heard. I'd never actually seen any, but I heard that that's something that happened too. So
that'd be crazy if like that just starts blowing up on TikTok and like other like media outlets, like, oh, we have like hella Gap, Yeezy Gap here.
Yeezy Gap.
Or you see like 350s like at Ross and you're like, what?
But I guess the bigger question now for probably everybody is like, what's next?
Yeah, what does Adidas do and Gap do without Kanye now? Which is like one of those questions, like, you know, people want to know, because like a lot of what Adidas was doing with the streetwear culture was tied into Kanye, and like that was kind of like their main source of like coolness, like cool factor to like Adidas.
Yeah, like their foot into the door for like streetwear, like any type of like even sneaker culture
and stuff. Yeah, like, so like they don't really have anybody else outside of Kanye they're like utilizing, basically. Like, he was like the main like
creative
like streetwear guy, like, you know,
pushing it forward, like the brand, at least for like Adidas.
So like it is going to be interesting to see what Adidas does without him. I don't know, like they like you've like I've talked about, like, they have one of the biggest iconic artists like with them right now, and they haven't really utilized him at all. Like, they've had a couple drops with him and like all of his stuff is sold out, but it's been like, I don't know, like, you should be doing way more with Bad Bunny. Like, Bad Bunny is,
that's a fact.
You know, he is a freaking, like,
so slept on, dude.
Yeah, like all of his albums have been fire. Like, I love all his music. I love him as a person. I love, like, what he represents, what he does for his, like, you know.
He's and it's interesting because I feel like he's so polar opposite to what's happening now with Kanye.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you have somebody who has so much more core and beliefs that you guys are set the standard for, but are not, like, utilizing him for products as much as, like, Kanye.
Like, he's not a controversial figure at all. He's like all about like making sure his country is good. Like, if they got they got hit with the hurricane, like, he was all about like pushing, like, you know, like people to like help donate and like take like help Puerto Rico out. Like, he's really big with like all the communities. Like, he cares about people's like feelings and like, I don't know, like, he's like a great figure. He's just, like, he's a great guy, you know.
He seems like a great guy because we don't know him,
but exactly. But we're, you know,
what we hear from what you see,
like, just seeing everything has been so organic. And I've always like thought of Bad Bunny as like the Latin music's like Kanye, because everything he's done is so organic, and it's so like, he's like so fashion forward, and he makes music, like, the music he makes is so good.
Yeah, it's good music.
And it's like,
he's a good creative as well.
Yeah, he's just a good creative. And like, you know, Michael Jordan didn't make the shoes. He didn't design the shoes. Michael Jordan had Tinker Hatfield. So like, like, having somebody, like a team, like designing stuff for Bad Bunny, shoes, like clothing, and like just like being able to talk to them and like tell them like what he's feeling and like what he wants to, like, this is what I want to represent my brand.
Right. kind of like, he might not be the designer, mm-hmm. but like you're saying, like copy the same formula like that Nike is in. It's like you can have somebody who's a creative,
mm-hmm.
and then have somebody who also can have their input to
yeah.
kind of push that product
forward. Exactly. And somebody that understands the creative and like
the design, are,
like, the designs he likes, his sensibilities, like what he wants to like portray, like, you know, what he wants to give out to the culture.
Yeah.
And like you don't need Yeezy. You have Bad Bunny.
Yeah. Well, I think the big thing is, if Adidas can capture that and see,
yeah.
I think my biggest question personally was like, how much do they really care about that culture,
mm-hmm.
and how much do they really want to be a part of it? Because it's like, you know, you've had Bad Bunny signed. It's not like he just got signed.
Yeah, it's been like this.
He's been on the team.
Mm-hmm.
We were talking about Jerry Lorenzo has been on the team too.
Fear God.
He's got the Fear of God products and stuff like that were supposed to be coming out that we're still waiting for.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't heard a thing about it.
Yeah.
So it's like, Adidas, like, if you're going to move forward with, you know, removing one of the bigger icons and wanting to bring, like, move that culture forward, it's like you already have some people that you can work with,
mm-hmm.
And maybe bring on other people and
yeah.
stuff like that, too, mm-hmm. that can kind of fill that gap that you're missing. But who knows? I really don't know.
I don't know what's going to happen. Like, Adidas has kind of just been, like, just shrugging, shrugging away, you know what I mean? And it's just, like, really frustrating because, like, Nike has, like, really just, like, destroyed them, like,
in the last two or three years,
like Adidas had a good like run with Kanye, and then it just like Travis Scott came in, and then just kind of like,
yeah. Well, they, I mean, he was with Adidas for 9 years, right? Since 2016.
Kanye, yeah.
So it's been a while, dude. Like, it's crazy how long like that relationship actually lasted.
Mm-hmm.
And it's crazier that like it just happened like within a day.
Yeah.
No, well, it was like obviously a lot of things were happening, but from one night to another, mm-hmm. it's just like an announcement of immediate termination. Yeah.
Like there's not like no
yeah, but Adidas, like, you know, like I personally, like, I don't see any other products that I think I would want moving forward from mm-hmm. with Adidas, up until like outside of a few of the Bad Bunny shoes, but it's a hard model for me to like want to buy.
The 484, I think.
It's just kind of harder for me to style with some of those.
Yeah, it's a bulkier shoe.
Yeah, it's a really, really bulky. And I have nothing wrong with bulky shoes, but I feel mm-hmm. like just that shoe in general, just not like the best. It's decent. I would rate it as decent.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. Like, I love Bad Bunny and I'll buy anything that he makes.
I think adding his name to it adds a lot more.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, okay, cool. But like, can we get more? Can we get different silhouettes, like actual like original designs too? That'd be sick.
Yeah, an original design, I feel like that would be crazy. And I don't know, like I said, it goes back to my question, like how much work is Adidas going to put in to be a part of this culture and give the fans what they want, or give like sneakerheads what they want and stuff like that?
Yeah, we'll see. Again, yeah, they have the tool, they have like all these good people, mm-hmm. all these good creatives and like artists like in their team, but they're not doing anything with it.
Yeah, and another good perspective about it too is like Adidas also, like, because I think it's not that they might not want to be a part of it, but they might be structurally looking at it where some of their money comes from, and a lot of mm-hmm. the money revenue does come from a lot of athletic wear and stuff like that too, so they mm-hmm. have another cool subculture, which is going to be like, you know, soccer is a huge
I think they're like the biggest soccer shoe,
so it's mm-hmm. like they might have their entire money and focus on that subculture, and you know, streetwear, or you know, might be, oh, it makes us some money, but it's not as important to us as what's mm-hmm. the bread maker, at least people in the boardroom, because you got to think about that too. It's
like, yeah, no, for sure,
the business structure has always been mm-hmm. like, what's making us money, let's keep pumping that.
Yeah,
you know.
I just think it's important to like be in the culture and stay in like the conversation.
Yeah,
I think if you like you know, if you're just like completely like absent from like like fashion and like the trends, like I think it kind of like devalues your brand,
a little bit,
you know, so like bit. I think it's important to have like, you know,
those people
like pushing fashion and like the trends forward, you know, and that's how you're going to grow as a company, and you're going to have like innovation, you know.
Yeah,
so I don't know what they're going to do. Hopefully, like, you know, they actually do something with Bad Bunny or Jerry Lorenzo, like
he's something.
That guy's awesome,
somebody
too,
else, you know? Like you were saying, mm-hmm. Travis Scott moves over to Adidas,
that'd be wild. No. I don't think that would happen.
Yeah, I think he loves Nike way too much, and like
I think like they've wrote for him too, like after all his controversies and what happened with Astroworld, you know.
Yeah, so
like,
I don't know.
Kind of like, and McDonald's too. McDonald's got them.
Yeah,
he's got his. They got their Travis Scott's back too, which is crazy.
But I mean, now looking at, I guess, that and Kanye, I don't know. Like, I don't know. I just feel like what's there's like a thin line, I guess, as far as like now who you bring on and stuff like that, mm-hmm. when it comes to like the controversy,
the just like bringing on somebody that, like, you know, I don't really know what they're gonna do.
Gap, on the other hand, I think they're just done for.
Yeah, like, again, like, they weren't even in the conversation in the first place until, yeah, like, Yeezy was a part of it, and, like, then he started bringing some of the designs over.
The thing, too, with that was, like, I feel like there was always, like, the way that they dropped stuff was always, like, weird. It was never, like, super accessible. Things that were getting pre-ordered were taking, like, a year for you to get. So yeah, it's like, yeah, they never really figured out their formula, and like, it, I think it took like 2 years for them to actually even release like a single product.
Like, yeah, like the hoodies was, and stuff. Yeah. Yeah,
so I'm all like,
yeah, because it was announced a couple of years ago. Like, yeah, he signed a $100 million deal with them. I think.
Yeah, that was, and that was like, I think, pre-COVID, like 2019.
Yeah.
So it's like, dude, it took you guys this long, and I still never felt their presence as big as something that Adidas did. So I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Gap, again, I think that maybe they were just out of it. They weren't really that involved in that creative and stuff. And
yeah, again, I think like a lot of these companies just like, we're like, here's the money, just do what you want to do.
Just do something. Yeah.
Yeah.
And
bring us the culture, please. And it's like, they don't have anybody like kind of like,
yeah,
what is it, like supervising him or like kind of like,
you know. Yeah, yeah, I think like, okay, and then Foot Locker and like Champs, I feel like they're gonna struggle too. Like,
yeah,
that's just another product. And I think we had heard before where Nike actually even was thinking about removing some of their products and making it exclusive to just their websites. So for me, it's like, when I saw that, it was kind of like Foot Locker is slowly starting to like remove those products that brings consumers in.
Yeah.
So in a business standpoint, I'm like, what are you really going to be selling that, like, in the future? Not right now, obviously.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
But like in the next couple of year or two or whatever ends up rolling out, is like, what are your products are you going to be carrying that's going to keep making you guys profitable? Like, they're already struggling for to like try to keep that like that going and stuff in the business and stuff like that. So
yeah, I just saw a bunch of Team Jordans.
Yeah, right. But and even that, like, with the whole issue with manufacturing and blah blah blah, like, they can't even hold shoes in store anymore. Like, you go in and half the time they don't have your size. Like,
yeah, that, or like everything is like built into like the app, so they have to sell it to the person that's like got it off the app. They can't sell
like
it
raffles
to,
and stuff.
Yeah,
like
they can't actually, like, the cool products they have to, like, you know, hold for people that actually got them off the app, and not actually, you can't have a walk-in experience in getting a
shoe.
The
walk-in experience is definitely done for, and it's just, I think it's getting harder for that business structure as well. And yeah, I don't know, moving forward with them either. I think like the best positions, like, anyway, out of all these companies, I think Adidas just still has, like I said, they still have the soccer stuff going and Forum athletic wear.
Yeah.
So they'll be fine, I feel like, you know, but I feel like the repercussions for Gap and like Foot Locker, like at least for that subculture, might be kind of like slowly starting to die. Well, Gap's for sure dead, but Foot Locker, I feel like, I just gotta make that clear. Yeah, it's like Gap's dead.
Yeah, I don't even know where Gap store's at. So
yeah, like I don't know, bro. Yeah. Like, but you know, hey, other people might still shop there. So
yeah, and I think it's like also interesting to just like to see what the future of Kanye's brand, of Yeezy brand, is gonna be, and like the value and the resale of the shoes. And that's like a big question we've been getting asked.
The biggest question.
Like, are they gonna shoot up in price? And like, for me, I don't think so. Not maybe, like, I would say give it like 4 to 5 years when you're actually gonna see them actually maybe be worth something, because they're gonna be so rare.
Yeah,
but like, I don't see them like actually shooting up in price. Maybe a couple pairs, like the Turtle Doves and like the more rarer pairs, but like the average 350, you know, the Foam Runners, the Yeezy Slides, they've all been kind of already like more at a price point where you can actually purchase them without it being so expensive. So I don't see them going up another $100, you know. I don't think that would happen, because they've already been mass produced to such a big point that like the only ones I see are like the more rare colorways, like the ones that they didn't make a lot of. They might go up,
the exclusive ones.
Like, if you just start buying random 350s and you expect them to shoot up to $500-$600, I don't think that's gonna happen.
Yeah,
it's got to be an actual like good colorway that's like really sought after. They might go up in price.
Yeah, I think the originals, like you're saying, kind of like some of those OG popular models, like, for me too. I think what's gonna happen in the next couple like week or two is we get emotional, you know, as like sellers or resellers and consumers who start thinking, oh, everything's gonna become so scarce, so like you have to get it before it's like no longer available ever. There's gonna be a lot of emotional buying into things, and so that's gonna immediately jump up, because obviously it's basic economics, you know, supply and demand. It's like everybody's gonna want it for like these next couple of days.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
gonna
yeah.
shoot up, and people are going to obviously hold on to them, and nothing's really going to happen probably for like the next couple months. At least we won't hear anything, and so slowly you'll see a trickle down effect.
Yeah, exactly.
But I think how you're saying the long term, in the next couple of years, like how you said, turtle doves, anything that's like from the first original run will probably increase in value. You saw it happen with the Red Octobers and like a majority of the Nike shoes go for like a lot.
$10,000, $5,000,
but you got to look at the bigger picture of why those went up, and it's because it was such a collector's item. It's no longer just a shoe. It's now become a collector's item for somebody to look at and appreciate more for the art and the history. You know, and so you got to look at it more in the art perspective and a collector's perspective with those shoes. It's not just kind of like, oh, are they going to wear this shoe? And you're saying there's so many other colorways that were mass produced, and like how you're saying, I feel like that would be a pretty dumb purchase to go and buy everything that was just generally released. And mass produced.
Like I can see the zebras, the belugas being like a better shoe if you wanted to buy them. But again, I'm not going to like tell anybody to buy anything right now because it's such a like,
it's so tumultuous,
I don't know what's going on.
It's going to be jumping back and forth, I feel like. But the best thing I would say is buy things that you appreciate, buy things that you like, buy things that you're going to probably later down the line be like, I'm glad I purchased this and will be happy, whether it's worth a lot or if it's worth nothing. So
And I don't know if you want to talk about anything else, like
I think that kind of it's just like I said, very vague, kind of talk about kind of what we see for resale and stuff like that, especially for all of our followers. I want to hear their perspectives and kind of see where they think things are going to go for them. One thing we didn't talk about is like, if he does make his own shoe, actually, like, where does that go?
Actually, that's a good point, because like, he's talked about making brick and mortar stores, like Yeezy stores, and so like, obviously he's not gonna be able to like sell to Foot Locker and Champs and like any other retailer, because they're already like, you know, got all of his product out of there. So he would have to do everything on his own, and have to be all original designs as well. Like, it can't be anything that like
he's already previously designed.
Exactly. So I don't know how that would play out, to be honest, because that's going to be a big financial, like, it's going to be like, if he opens like 10 stores, like, that's going to be a lot of money.
Yeah, like, he needs to. And I think he was saying in an interview that he actually has like 120 million.
Yeah, like, I know his net worth has just gone down to like 400 million, which is like, we're talking about huge numbers here, but like, to invest into like actually the infrastructure of building shoes, stores, employees, payroll, healthcare, like,
it's gonna take a lot.
It's a lot you have to put into it to actually start like your own like chain of stores,
And like the also, PR too. I think people sleep on the whole, like, you know, the research and stuff that he's gonna have to do, and like the money he has to put in just to get samples, just to get things off the ground.
Having to hire designers, having to hire a whole team, get a building, all these things he's gonna have to do. I don't think he's gonna actually do it.
I think he's gonna shoot for it. But realistically, I don't see it happening anytime soon, because like I said, people need to take into account how long it actually takes to
do. It'd be that, like, 5-year thing.
Yeah.
Like, and then like, I think you would maybe have like 2 stores, maybe like one in like New York and one, or like maybe Chicago. That'd be cool. And then one in like LA or something. Like, you would have like, it'd be like Supreme, kind of like just having like couple stores.
Super limited.
And that might work.
I feel like that formula could work. You're right.
Him, but again, it's just going to be up to him and where his mindset's at and what he wants and actually wants to do.
And the biggest thing is, he's going to need a partnership and people to work with.
Yeah.
Right now, it doesn't seem like he wants to work with anybody. So that's another thing on him too. Is like, and I had said that previously on one of our other podcasts, when I said the thing is with his partnerships, it's like, who's going to want to partner with him?
Yeah.
You know, and and now we're looking at, he's on his own now.
For real.
And so, also online was another big platform. E-commerce would probably be his best start before he actually goes into like a brick and mortar, if he was thinking about costs and stuff like that.
It's going to be wild. I think we're going to have to wait like a couple of years before we actually see actual Yeezy branded stuff again.
And I think in this position, it's the best thing for him. Like, just go to work, bro.
Go to work, you know, and just like, you know, put all this stuff away. Like,
exactly.
Do everything you're doing. Just go away. Go to work. And just make music and like, you know, make clothing and, you know, don't involve yourself with all these things that's been happening. So,
yeah, but who knows?
But we'll see, you know, again, we'll see. But yeah, that was a quick episode for you guys. We just wanted to talk about everything that's going on. Hit us up on TikTok. We'll be posting videos there too.
Yep.
Follow us on Instagram.
At,
you know,
Shoebox.
YouTube, guys. Like and subscribe, please. Hit that bell. Thank you guys. But yeah. Thank you guys so much. Have a great day.
Peace.